NITBOG, a highly resourceful and motivated forensic analyst that works alongside with law enforcement agencies and in all levels of investigation sectors. Depending on the type of case on hand, he might be in charge of analysing either a single device or an entire network to retrieve digital evidence through the process of identification, extraction, preservation, and documentation. The problem is, there are so many revolutionary changes in the IT field, and sometimes, based on the severity and urgency of the case, an immediate investigation is required. Some major challenges in the field consist of time, location, scrambled information, and the lack of standardized tools, especially for Cisco network devices. This is where Project BAT is designed for. It is a portable toolkit that allows forensic analysts to retrieve network data from Cisco-based network devices. It's built with a foolproof design that assists in analyzing raw Cisco iOS crashdown files that is based on Cisco's initial forensic standards and guidelines. Before moving on to demonstrate on how the toolkit works, we will be using GNS3 as the virtual network environment to help assist in demonstrating and showcase the toolkit's function. A Cisco 7200 series router will be set up with basic network configurations and simulated with a test crash command issued to the device. This will allow us to extract a Cisco crashdown file directly from the device for the toolkit analysis function. The program is also coded and running on Python 3 with PyCharm to assist in compiling and debugging the codes. The toolkit will also be using the following libraries to support the functions. Now let's run the toolkit. The toolkit is programmed to accomplish three different functions. Option A, to collect the evidence. Option B, to analyze. And option C, to compare, running, and startup config. Let's proceed with option A. Here, we will enter the remote device IP address and credentials. The toolkit is programmed to execute and retrieve all of the router's configuration based on the Cisco's initial forensic guidelines and standards. This includes history of months input, cloud details, startup configurations, routing table information, CTP information, ARP table, router's interface, details of IP cache flow, and many others. The retrieved data will be stored in individual text files and also compiled into a PDF file for further analysis to be done later on. This allows the analyst to retrieve and collect network device information with ease. The following depicts how the PDF will look like.
So moving on, this is the source code for option A to collect Cisco forensic evidence. It utilizes the class called SSH to initialize the IP address, username, password, and of course the enable password. So these three fields are required to authenticate itself after performing a connection to this IP address. So of course for option A, we have a list of commands in the form of an array. And these commands are listed based on the Cisco iOS forensic guidelines. So of course, to perform the remote SSH connection, we will be using the Parabico library to connect ourselves into a remote network device before running a series of commands by looping the command list. So after running these commands, it will actually put the output into various text files before closing the SSH connection and then merging all of these outputs together into a single file using this make.makePDF method. So after collecting all the outputs from the command list into a single file called combine.pdf using the makePDF method, we have a file of evidence that the forensic analyst can use to perform its analysis and derive into a conclusion. So as you can see here, there's the show history all whereby it shows all the history of commands that were entered into the network device and the timestamp that is associated with the commands. So what the forensic analyst can derive from this information is that if a command is input into the network device at a period whereby it's not supposed to, then we can say that there is a suspicious activity that could possibly be happening at that hour. So from here, we can see that this is the list of history in that particular network device. And of course, after the history, we have the clock details and of course, the show startup config. So essentially, the show startup config shows the startup configuration of the network device. And of course, we can use this information to compare with the backup configuration file in the company backup server to see if there are any changes or suspicious commands that were entered into this startup configuration file. So of course, moving on, one of the important ones are the show IP route, whereby a malicious user could possibly be injecting a poison route in routing table and then routing the traffic into his or her subnet. This could also prove to be a very valuable evidence for the forensic analyst. So of course the CDP table detail, whereby if there are actually suspicious physical hardware that were plugged into the device, this show CDP neighbor detail command will be able to show the information of its neighboring device. So of course there is the show IP address resolution protocol, whereby if IP address is not supposed to be leased out, then of course, so of course we have the show IP ARP, whereby we can see the IP to the address binding, and the address is not supposed to be leased out, then we can actually conclude that there is a suspicious activity that is going on in the network device. So of course there are the show IP interface, whereby if interfaces that were not supposed to be up is currently up, then we can add it into the evidence collection, prove our point and reduce the chances of false positives. So of course with all this information. Of course another important point is the show sockets, whereby by showing these sockets we can actually see what kind of sockets open on the network device, and then we can see what kind of ports is open and is not supposed to open to the external, and then we can add this piece of evidence to the evidence collection. So of course another important point is the show login, whereby there are information that is triggered and it shows the events of this network device, which could prove to be valuable to the forensic analyst.
Now let's use the function B of the toolkit. In this demonstration, we'll be choosing a generated crashdown file that we have simulated on a network device on GNS3. Here we enter the file path of the crashdown file. A variety of analysis options will appear. Given the different type of information here, we will proceed with option 13, which will compile all data from all options into a combined PDF file. We can then enter the desired PDF file name. Information will then be able to be relayed back to the Cisco tech case and decode them using Cisco proprietary tools. Overall, this speeds up and ease the process of digital evidence collection and documentation on Cisco network devices. The following depicts how the information will look like in the PDF file.
Okay, so option B of analyzing the Cisco forensic evidence will be utilizing the source code in extract.py to process the information and then portray and showcase the evidence in a human readable format. So as you can see here, after processing and running file against this extract.py, a manual list will be generated with option 1 to 12. So some of the more important options are like option 11 and option 4, whereby option 4 shows malloc and free traces right here, and of course 11 to show the register memory dump. So just by looking at this register memory dump, a skilled forensic analyst can go to a lower level of assembly language to derive what kind of assembly commands such as move or jump that were executed on the network device. So with that being said, this actually requires a very skilled analyst to analyze this information that is listed out for them. So of course, with that being said, there are actually other options which could help him or her in deriving a far more accurate conclusion.
The final function of the toolkit, which is comparing the running configuration to the startup configuration of the specific network device. The main purpose of the following function acts as a fast and easy way to assist in determining whether if the device has been compromised or to recover the network configuration. We will enter the specific network device and allow the toolkit to automate the analysis process. The program will list out the following legends: question mark for incremental differences, plus for configuration found only in the running config and not in startup config, minus will show the vice versa. Here's how it will be indicated. The legends will be right beside the configuration figure to showcase and allow the analyst to easily spot the differences.
So for option C of comparing the running configuration and the startup configuration file, we'll be utilizing the compare.py and the shared class called SSH. So for option C, we'll be actually using the compare files method and the compare output to differentiate the commands between the running configuration and the startup configuration. So similarly to option A, we'll be using the Paramico Python library to perform a SSH connection to this remote network device before running these commands that is highlighted right here. So after running the commands and getting the outputs, we will then be calling the compare outputs using this difflib Python library to compare the differences. So as you can see here in this output, after running the commands and performing a successful connection, a list of output will be generated. So as you can see here at the end of the program, there's a legends with. So as you can see here at the end of the program, there's actually a legends with symbols and its meaning. So with the question mark representing an incremental difference, the plus showing that the commands are in the running configuration but not in the startup configuration. And of course the minus that shows the command that is removed from the running configuration. So as you can see here, a simple walkthrough will be a question mark, incremental difference such as the time. And of course, following which will be the addition of these commands such as IP, DHCP, snooping, read and pen. And then previously, it was in the running configuration but now it's being removed. Of course, there are additional commands such as additional VLANs being added to the configuration file and descriptions. Suspicious descriptions and this IP access list and many more. So of course, with that being said, how is this information valuable for a forensic analyst? So the comparison of these two files allow the analyst to derive into a conclusion or help his judgment in performing a forensic analysis. So you can see here, just by looking at the differences, we can kind of deduce that a suspicious activity had happened at the network device when a suspicious access list were added to the device, or possibly a VLAN ID that were previously not in the device and now it actually is.